Unless you've been living under a rock, you've probably heard of cryptocurrencies. They're digital forms of money that have their own shifting values and are slowly being accepted by more and more businesses.
The conceit is that they're not regulated by any government, but by users using blockchain technology.
This week, we cracked the code on blockchain technology, where it started, how it's used, and its crazy future.
Blockchain ensures that there's no one centralized force, like a bank, making sure that people aren't abusing the system.
They created this technology so that it would be very hard to hack, and in the case of cryptocurrency, any amount of money you could possibly steal trying to hack into a system would take way more time and energy to actually be profitable.
Today, blockchain technology is being used in really interesting ways, from managing humanitarian crises to controlling international supply chains.
But how is a technology originally created for keeping tabs on cryptocurrency transactions assisting so many other business sectors today? Is it really even private?
And most importantly, where does it come from and how the heck does it work? Good morning, class, and welcome to Blockchain 101.
Dain, there's just me in here.
No, Andrew, I know there's no people here. This is like my dream. Can you just support me, please?
Okay,
thank
fine.
You. A lot of people think that Bitcoin and blockchain are synonymous. They're actually not. Blockchain is the technology behind Bitcoin that allows Bitcoin to even exist at all. It's a lot like an internal combustion engine and how it made the car ubiquitous, but it also powers things like lawnmowers and weed whackers. A white paper was published in 2008 by a person who uses the pseudonym Satoshi Nakamoto that described and explained Bitcoin and its philosophy, its technology, and its functionality. But it wasn't until 2014 when the wider investment community really took action with blockchain, seeing the value in its decentralized system of peer-to-peer transactions. Now, Andrew, can you show us how blockchain works?
I sure can, Dain, and thank you for calling on me. Blockchain works like a game of telephone. Basically, the first person or user chooses a word or phrase, and then they whisper that word or phrase to the person in front of them. This happens down the line until you reach the last person playing. Then they stand up and repeat the phrase or word that they heard. Excuse me. Now, if you've played this game before, you probably know that when that person stands up at the end and says that word or phrase, it's dramatically different from the word or phrase that we started with. This is a perfect example of how an online ledger can get corrupted. Because if a prankster or hacker wants to corrupt data that would be otherwise honest, they can, without any protection from any outside sources. But now imagine that a teacher, which represents a node, listens to every whisper and makes sure that the phrase stays the same. The prankster can't change anything up, which keeps all the data honest and unchanging. Now this entire classroom is a secure block. And if every other classroom in the building was playing the same game of telephone with all the teachers or nodes checking all of their information against each other, you could call the entire school a secure blockchain network.
Did somebody in here say blockchain?
What is blockchain in simplest terms?
It's a data structure that allows us to trace a train of data back to its initial provenance, and that is really hard to alter.
What is it?
Okay. If you're talking about a public blockchain like Bitcoin, then what you're talking about is a ledger of transactions. It's kind of like a big shared Excel spreadsheet in the sky. But instead of being part of the cloud, where you might have heard that the cloud is just somebody else's computer, the blockchain is really all of our computers working together at once, so that after some amount of time, and in Bitcoin it's about an hour usually, that everybody sees the same thing, no matter where you are.
But what about beyond Bitcoin? I mean, people are doing more than just paying each other with this kind of stuff, right?
The Internet of Information that we're familiar with is great if you have a picture and you want to email that to someone else and now you have two pictures and everyone's happy. But it's really, really bad if you want to send something and then not have it anymore. So whether that's a dollar or a land title, it's not just about paying each other anymore and representing currency, but really any kind of marketplace where you'd want to move a representation of something you own around the world.
So what do you do with blockchain?
I run a company that's called Clovyr, and what we're doing is trying to make it a lot easier for people to build those kinds of applications I was talking about on top of these blockchains. Whether you want to be a business that's running inside one of those private consortiums and it's, you know, Fortune 100 companies working together, or you're somebody at home that's working on a hobby project or building their next startup that they think is going to become a big business someday, we want you to be able to use the same tools so that these things can ultimately come together.
And what's the future of blockchain?
Well, let me get out my crystal ball. Nobody knows yet, and it really depends how the technology continues to evolve. It could drive democratization and globalization and free flow of jobs and help people kind of meet each other around the world and come together. But on the other hand, we have to be really careful about what information we are putting on that blockchain. Until the privacy thing is solved in a bulletproof way, which it's just not yet, there's always the risk that any information that's on a blockchain could be seen by anybody. So if we end up with Twitter for our bank account, imagine what Twitter for the national economy looks like. We could see a whole new era of cyber war. So guys, do you know what the blockchain is now?
Yes.
Yes.
Happy to help.
Thank you so much.
Bye. Amber just gave us both a great lesson on blockchain tech, but now we have a lesson for you. It's about domain.com. Domain.com has all your .com and .net domain needs, and they also have really cool, intuitive website builders. So if you have a professional vision, you want to get a professional website going, head to domain.com, try them out.
Now, the people at domain.com really love ContecTual, and to show their love for us and for you, they're giving you a discount. You can buy domain names, web hosting, and email services, and use the coupon code ContecTual at checkout for 20% off your purchase.
We should go build a professional website right now.
Now.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Blockchain. It's a concept that felt so alien at the beginning of this episode, and it's finally making so much sense. Andrew, why are you on your phone?
My mom just asked me what I did today, and I'm just explaining blockchain over text.
Oh, right on. Spread the knowledge.
And the wealth.
You're fitting that all in one text.
Mm-hmm. She's gonna hate me.
Thank you so much for watching ContecTual.
On our next episode, we create a digital Rube Goldberg machine using IF.
And we get pizza.
So be sure to subscribe to our channel.
And click the tiny bell for notifications.
If you click the bell, then you'll get notified.
Yeah, it's that simple.